The Cool Mitt. Yeah. The Cool Mitt. Palmer Cooling. Okay, I promised to talk about Palmer Cooling. Well, I'll do it now. Palmer Cooling, they changed the Q&A format. What can I say? This is like teaching in the classroom. All right, very briefly, the Palmer Cooling, which is essentially placing, you can cool the core of the body most quickly by placing cold objects on the hands, the bottoms of the feet, or on the top of the face because of the arrangement of vasculature. Normally, you've got this arteries, capillaries, veins things, but at those locations in the body, you skip the capillaries and you can basically, you're not really passing cool into the body, but you're cooling off the core of the body more quickly. And if you do that in between sets of exercise or during a run or cycling, you can dramatically increase your ability to continue. I actually use the Cool Mitt for cognitive work, but you don't need a Cool Mitt. Sorry, Cool Mitt, guys. You can just get a thing of ice water or just very cold water. And you, I know it sounds trivially easy, but you're actually just cooling your core by putting your hands or even one hand on a relatively cold thing of water or ice, but not so cold that it constricts the vasculature there. This is the incredible work of my colleague at Stanford, Dr. Craig Heller. Why wouldn't more people do this if you can double the amount of endurance, believe it or not, or double the number of sets of exercise you can do, or feel more alert and do more cognitive work? Why wouldn't more people do it? Because people just don't do it. And it sounds crazy. It really sounds crazy, but it's a real thing. And I wish more people would do it. The athletes at Stanford do it. People in the military do it. So people who know, and they use it, enjoy it. It's just, it's almost like, seems too off target from what you're trying to accomplish. I don't know. For some reason, people are finally on board breathing, like in a specific way as a useful tool. A few years ago, no one was into that.